على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك. أما بعد، فاتقوا الله حق التقوى واستمسكوا من دينكم بالعروة الوثقى، واعلموا أن أجسامنا على النار لا تقوى. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. ثم أما بعد، أيها المؤمنون، the messenger عليه الصلاة والسلام, he sent a messenger to the Romans, and this messenger was killed by the Romans. And the messenger عليه الصلاة والسلام had prepared himself to retaliate in order to protect the Islamic government and so that the Romans do not try to attack it. He had prepared the Sahaba radiallahu anhum for the battle of Tabuk. And he had informed them about this. Normally the Messenger alayhi salatu salam would not inform them about where he's heading towards. But he told them this time due to Tabuk being so far, so they could prepare accordingly. When the Messenger alayhi salatu salam had set off with 30,000 men to face the Romans, the biggest army that the Messenger alayhi salatu salam ever led, all the Sahaba were commanded to go except those who had excuses. There was a Sahabi known as Ka'b ibn Malik radiallahu anhu arzah. He narrates this story in Sahih Muslim, where he says that I had never stayed behind from a battle that the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam went to, except the battle of Badr, because it was optional. And the intention was not a battle, but it was to seize the caravan. And I had taken part in Bay'atul Aqaba, the pledge of allegiance to the Messenger alayhi salatu by the Ansar in Aqaba. So when the Prophet alayhi salatu set out, Ka'ab hadn't gone yet. He said, I was a very wealthy man, lived a very comfortable life. So I took my time in getting ready for the battle. And then the Prophet alayhi salatu had left Medina. I told myself, I'll catch up, he says. And he said, I procrastinated and procrastinated and procrastinated until it was too late and I wouldn't be able to make it to Tabuk. He says, when I was in Medina, I was panicking. What am I going to say to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam when he returns? In Tabuk, the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, he asked about Ka'b. He said, where's Ka'b ibn Malik? Imagine the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam, he has 30,000 men and he's aware of the Sahaba. He's asking about Ka'b specifically, where is he? One of the Sahaba, he said, Ya Rasulullah, Ka'b is a man who, he's very wealthy, he's very comfortable. He probably spent a lot of time looking at himself in the mirror, and that's why he didn't come. Mu'adh bin Jabal radiallahu anhu had this. And he said, Ya Rasulullah, we don't know about Ka'b except goodness. And we only know of him khair. He said, perhaps, Ya Rasulullah, he has an excuse that stopped him from coming with us. Ka'b, he says, when narrating the story, that Sahabi who said that about me, he had every right to say that about me. But my brother Mu'adh, he defended my honor. May Allah tabarak wa ta'ala reward him, he said, which I did not deserve. The Prophet alayhi salatu after the battle would come back to Medina. And normally when you come back to Medina, the first place you'll go to is the masjid. And normally those who stay behind from the battles, they go to him, telling him their excuses. So Ka'b, he was thinking, what am I going to say to the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam? Should I make an excuse like these people who normally do, and the Prophet alayhi salatu seeks forgiveness for them, and he lets them go and he judges them by what's apparent, even though their excuses are lame? Or should I tell him the truth that I have no excuse? He decided to go to the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam and to tell him the truth. The Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam listened to him. And after he'd finished, he did not give him any verdict. Ka'b had left. He's worrying, he's concerned, he's thinking, what is going to happen? And then he asked, were there others? He asked the Sahaba, were there others who were like me, who stayed behind just like me? And he was told there are two other Sahaba who also remained behind, Hilal and Murara. And these two Sahaba, when he heard about them, they were two who participated in the Battle of Badr. And he would often hear from the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam, do you not know that Allah Azza wa Jal ittala ala ahli Badr? He looked at the people of Badr and he said to them, I'malu ma shi'tum fa inni qad ghafartu lakum. Do as you wish, for verily I have forgiven you because of the great virtue. So when he realized these two people had also were also in the same situation as him, it gave him a little bit of comfort. But then came the first test. His family, his companions, they came to him and said to him, Ya Ka'b, why did you get yourself in trouble? You could have done the same as others. Tell the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam an excuse and he will accept it and he will seek forgiveness for you, and that forgiveness perhaps will expiate your mistake. And they kept insisting this and repeating this to him to the extent that Ka'b said, I doubted myself. I almost went back to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam and lied. But he said, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala made my heart firm and I refrained from that. And he passed that first test. And then came the second test, where the Prophet ﷺ commanded everyone to boycott Ka'b and his two companions. No one speaks to them. No one interacts with them. Nobody can have any sort of interaction with them at all. To the extent that Ka'b, he said, I'll go to the masjid and I'll see the Messenger ﷺ and I would greet him. I'll say, Assalamu alaikum. And I would be doubtful, did his lips move to respond to me? I would look at him and he would turn away from me. Imagine the difficulty that he's going through, Ka'b, because of his major mistake that he had committed. And then this boycott went on for 50 days. Even their family members are not speaking to them. Ka'b decided to isolate himself and to stay away from the people because he said there's no benefit being around them. And then he went to his cousin Abu Qatada and he said to him, Ya Aba Qatada, do you not know that I love Allah and His Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam? Abu Qatada didn't respond. He repeated three times. And the third time Abu Qatada said, Allahu A'lam, Allah knows best. I don't know if you love Allah and His Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam. This was something that stung his heart. And he remained in that state for the remainder of the time. And then came another test, where one of the leaders of the tribes, their governors, he had sent a letter to Ka'b. He had heard about Ka'b being boycotted, and Ka'b was a man who had great status among his people, respected, venerated. He sent a letter saying to Ka'b, Ya Ka'b, we have heard what is happening to you in Medina, and that you are being boycotted. We are going to give you a safe haven, refuge. Come to us. Ka'b radiallahu anhu read the letter and he knows it's from their leader. They're trying to exploit the situation, the disbelievers. Ka'b radiallahu anhu ripped it up. It is as if someone's giving you asylum. He ripped it up and he said, no way. I'm going to stay patient. When iman settles in the heart, nothing can waver it. And that was the case of Ka'b radiallahu anhu. After facing all these tests for 50 days, he and his two companions, and they were patient with that, persevered. After the period was over, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala revealed to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam that he had accepted their repentance at Fajr time. And when the ayah was revealed to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, the people, they rushed to give them glad tidings. Ya Ka'b ibn Malik, Abshir, قَدْ أَتَابَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْكَ. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala has accepted your repentance, Ya Ka'b, and his two companions. He says that I grabbed two garments that I had because that's the only thing that I had that I borrowed from someone. Because he had lost most of what he had. People had boycotted him. And I wore that to go meet the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam to greet him. And he said everyone was congratulating me, telling me that Allah tabarak wa ta'ala had accepted my repentance. And then he said, I went to the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam and he informed me of this. Where Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he says in Surah Tawbah, وَعَلَى الثَّلَاثَةِ الَّذِينَ خُلِّفُوا حَتَّى إِذَا ضَاقَتْ عَلَيْهِمُ الْأَرْضُ بِمَا رَحُبَتْ وَضَاقَتْ عَلَيْهِمْ أَنفُسُهُمْ وَظَنُّوا أن لا ملجأ من الله إلا إليه ثم تاب عليهم ليتوبوا إنه هو التواب الرحيم. And the three who stayed behind until the earth had become tight on them, Allah said, with everything in it. It is as if they're in tightness, they have nothing. But before that, Ka'ab radiallahu anhu had everything. And then Allah says, even their own anfus became tight on them. And they thought and they knew that there was no way of fleeing from Allah Azza wa Jal except to Him. And that's what they did. When they repented to Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala from this, and they were patient with this situation, then Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala accepted their repentance. Verily Allah is the one who often accepts the repentance, the most merciful. Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala accepted their repentance from the heavens, revealed the verse in the Qur'an that's going to be recited at Yawm Al-Qiyamah because of their sincere repentance. Imagine he took the first option and he told the Messenger Ali an excuse that got him the forgiveness of the Prophet Ali Salatu Wasalam, it would not got him this honor that's recited at Yawm Al-Qiyamah. Because of his sidq, his truthfulness. And that's what Allah says in Surah Tawbah, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهِ وَكُونُوا مَعَ الصَّادِقِينَ. Oh, you who believe, fear Allah and be amongst the truthful. And the Messenger عليه الصلاة والسلام, he says, عَلَيْكُمْ بِالصِّدْقَ فَإِنَّ الصِّدْقَ يَهْدِي إِلَى الْبِرِّ وَإِنَّ الْبِرَّ يَهْدِي إِلَى الْجَنَّةِ. That upon you is to be truthful. For verily truthfulness, it guides to all righteousness. And the righteousness guides to Jannah. And an individual doesn't constantly speak the truth except that he's recorded in the sight of Allah Azza wa Jal as a truthful one. And beware of lying, he said alayhi salatu wasalam. For verily lying, it leads to evil and immorality. And that leads to the hellfire. And an individual doesn't constantly lie except that he's recorded in the sight of Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala as a liar. Because of truthfulness and his courage, he repented to Allah Azza with that great repentance. And Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala documented and recorded that repentance in the Yawm Al-Qiyamah. We ask Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala to make us from those who repent Him sincerely. We ask Allah Azza to have mercy upon us. أقول ما تسمعون وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه وقد أفلح المستغفرون. الحمد لله على إحسانه والشكر له على توفيقه وامتنانه. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له تعظيما لشانه وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله الداعي إلى رضوانه صلى الله وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وخلانه ومن سار على نهجه واقتفى أثره إلى يوم الدين أما بعد أيها المؤمنون. Repentance is the act of worship that the believer he constantly should be in. It's an act of worship that you are constantly engaging in until you leave this world. And it's from the most beloved deeds to Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala. And Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala, He loves those who constantly, frequently repent to Him. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ التَّوَّابِينَ وَيُحِبُّ الْمُتَطَهِرِينَ. Verily Allah, He loves those who frequently repent to Him. And He loves those who purify themselves. And He جَلَّ فِي عُلَى, He tests, as Shaykh Hassan bin Taymi, He says, He tests His beloved slaves with certain sins, so that they repent to Him because of how much Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala loves repentance. As the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam, it tells us that Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala rejoices more than the individual who was traveling and had all his goods on his camel and he lost it and he found it and he rejoiced and he said out of happiness, oh Allah, you are my slave and I'm your Lord. He made a mistake because of how much he was rejoicing. Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala is happier than that individual when you repent to Him, Jalla fi ula. And Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala tells us that our success, it lies in repentance. وَتُوبُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا أَيُّهَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ. And repent to Allah Azza wa Jalla collectively, O believers, so that you can attain success. Success in this world and hereafter. فَأَمَّا مَنْ تَابَ وَآمَنَ وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا فَعَسَىٰ يَكُونَ مِنَ الْمُفْلِحِينَ. And as for those who repent and believe and do righteous deeds, they shall be amongst the successful. Allah Jalla fi ula, He says, it is the act of worship, the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam, he did it throughout his life and from his last statement that he said alayhi salatu wasalam was Allahumma ghafirli warhamni wa alhiqni bil rafiq al-a'la. Oh Allah, forgive me and have mercy upon me and let me join the highest companion. Teaching us that throughout your life until the last moments, this is what you should be engaging in. We ask Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala to aid us in that. And we ask Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala to make us from those who their repentance is accepted. And we ask Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala to guide us. And we ask Allah Azza wa Jalla to have mercy upon us. Allahumma inna nas'aluka al-huda wa al-tuqa wa al-afaf wa al-ghina. Allahumma ati nufusana taqwaha wa zakkiha anta khayru man zakkaha. أنت وليها ومولاها. اللهم إنا نسألك موجبات رحمتك وعزائم مغفرتك والغنيمة من كل بر والسلامة من كل إثم والفوز بالجنة والنجاة من النار. اللهم عز الإسلام والمسلمين وأذل شرك والمشركين ودمر اللهم أعداءك أعداء الدين واحمي حوزة الإسلام واجمع كلمتهم على الحق يا رب العالمين. اللهم انصر من نصر الدين واخذل من خذل الدين يا رب العالمين. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. اللهم اغفر لوالدينا، اللهم ارحمهم كما ربونا صغارا، اللهم جازهم بالإحسان إحسانا وبالسيئات عفوا وغفرانا. اللهم من كان منهم حيا فأطل في عمره وأحسن في عمله واختم لنا وله خاتمة الإحسان. ومن كان منهم ميتا فأنزل على قبره شآبيب الرحمات وافسح له في قبره مد بصره واجعل قبره روضة من رياض الجنة واجمعنا به في جناتك جنات النعيم. اللهم اشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين، اللهم اشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين وارحم موتانا برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. عباد الله، الله تبارك وتعالى commanded you with a matter that he started with himself and he made the end of second and he made the third. أيها المؤمنون إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. وقوموا إلى صلاتكم يرحمكم الله.